Just Too Hot getting back into the field. Wild Front and down on the inside. Last of all is Kaelma at the 500. And it's the debutante that does it well in front. Coming to the corner, Fabergino, a length and a half clear. Resistance Lies in Disguise down on the rail. Fourth is Ruby Amiss at the top of the straight. Then came Come On Over immediately under pressure. Noski went to work and Fabergino quickly races. Three in front from Ruby Amiss. Down on the inside, Lies in Disguise. Vital Blast getting held up. Has to switch back to the inside with 100 left to go. Fabergino shaken up in front. She's got them beaten here, this daughter of Machino. And Fabergino beat Vital Blast. Might have been a bit stiff too. Was getting home after threading its way through the field after getting badly held up. It's run second from either Lies in Disguise or Ruby Amiss. Followed then by Sophia's Secret, a handy performance. In behind them then came, at the head of the others, Just Too Hot. Followed further back, Kaelma, Come On Over. G Resistance blew out from the corner and beat One Home. That's Wild Front. She's a little extravagant, but she certainly has got some talent there. She was able to cross them within about 250. Fabergino found the fence. Vital Blast was strung up in behind heels coming into the straight. And certainly was hitting the line very well. I've just noticed Jared Noski's taking an eternity to pull her up. She just wants to go around another lap, Fabergino. And he's got a throttle hold on her, just trying to steady her down there after she'd virtually led all the way in this 1,000-metre race. She's by Machino. She's out of Miss Rosanna, a Dan Zero mare, and trained by Tiana Robertson. Number 7, Fabergino, beats 2, Vital Blast, and number 9, Lies in Disguise, third home. Fourth, number 5, Ruby Amiss. Sophia's Secret ran fifth in 58.28. Very, very good run, 58.28. He did have the persuader on her over the final 200 there and really got her switched on and made a run through the line. Vital Blast, make no mistake. All things being equal, would have made it very interesting. And I think that he's a smart two-year-old himself. Couple of good types there coming out of race one. So Fabergino on debut by Machino, the former outstanding son of Encosta de Lago from Miss Rosanna, Dan Zero mare for Jay Beasley, M. McDonough, Jay Teeny and AJ Anderson, trained by Tiana Robertson, who's got a nice filly on her hands here, and ridden by Jared Noski. Vital Blast was game in defeat. A bit unlucky there, having to switch right back to the inside. He got home terrific. Coming back in distance, found the 1,000 just a touch short by Vital Equine out of Absolute Cracker for Ian Rickwood, trained by Justine Erkelins, ridden by Aaron Mitchell, and Lies in Disguise, third, a Frost Giant filly from Ishy Babe for Brett Pope, B&M Coucher, Jason Cheatham, M. Bassett, Dr. M. Jenkins, M. Rossiter, S. Muir, trained by Brett Pope, ridden by Troy Turner. $2 even, $1.20. She was all the go, Fabergino. Vital Blast, $1.90, and Lies in Disguise, $4.40. In 58.28, home in 34.82. That's certainly a performance there. You couldn't ask too much more of those two-year-olds. And a length by a neck are the margins. Next of the day, race two, the Lavazza Handicap, over 1,600 at 3 minutes after one. And it's a field of eight. We have no changes in the next on the card. Let's go down to Adam. There was a fair bit of expectation on this filly this afternoon, and she has certainly delivered it in spades.
Yeah, there certainly was a lot of expectation. $3.50 into $2 here on course, and won like a good thing as well. Tiana, that was a pretty exciting performance on debut.
Yeah, it sure was. The horse has shown a fair bit in track work and at trials, so it's good to get the win on the board.
I guess there's still always a bit of nerves when you see a brilliant trial like that, but you have to do it on race day.
Yeah, for sure. There's nowhere down when you're winning a trial, so no, it's good to get the win.
She looks to be a bit of a hothead as well. Had two handlers, had the clerk of the course, and she was raring to go.
Yeah, she is a bit difficult, but she's getting better with each day, and she'll continue to improve.
I was listening to Darren McCauley's call there and then happened to get a glimpse of it and just wanted to go another lap, as he mentioned. Is this a horse that's just going to keep getting further and appreciate racing?
Well, you'd think so. On breeding and to look at her, you'd think that she'd get better over more ground, but she goes pretty hard and she's got that speed. So, you know, we'll stick to the 1,000 until she settles and take it from there.
Couldn't help but see the emotion. Means a lot to you and the team as well.
Yeah, it's good. You know, for the owner, it's his first season. He owns the stallion, so it's good to get a win on the board so early for him.
Certainly a nice big picture plan, and congratulations to all of you.
Yeah, for sure. Thanks.
There's Tiana Robertson, a trainer of Fabergina, which has taken out race number one. Jared Noski will be coming back in shortly. We're still waiting for the horse to come back in. That's how far it went, as Darren McCauley alluded to there. The horse just wanted to keep going. Jared Noski had a stranglehold of it, but it has taken an absolute mile to get this horse to settle and come back in. So all the other horses are dismounted. The jockeys have weighed in, and Jared Noski is still about to come in and do his little lap for winning. A really nice performance by number two, Vital Blast, attacking the line strongly. This gelding by Vital Equine is going to have a win shortly. Lies in Disguise on debut as well, put in a nice run. And Rubia's Miss, which was returning today after its only start in November behind Keeper Keen, and also its recent trial behind Fabergino, finishing fourth with a nice run there. So 7, 2, 9, and 5 were the finishing, or the top four in race number one here. Jared Noski just about to come in, and the horse now just relaxing a little bit more, but a nice win there for Connections. This filly by Maschino as well. For Tiana Robson, jumping from that wide gate, showing enough speed and finding the front easily. So we'll have a chat to Jared Noski. He's got another nice book of rides today. I'll be hoping to close that gap in on Brad Parnham, who sits number two in the Jockey Challenge with their battle at the moment. So Jared's just going to head around to the scale, so we'll have a chat to him as well while we walk there after a really nice performance. Jared, it's taken you an absolute mile to come in, mate, because this filly didn't want to pull up.
She had different ideas to me. Yeah, it's a very good win there.
Tell us about the performance. She sprung the gates quickly, and there was a lot of speed in this race, but she had no issues finding the front.
No, her first step was a little bit slow, but she mustered quick after that. And once she found the front, she pricked her ears up, which was good. And on the corner, she had a horse outside for a little bit, which she didn't really like. So let her go a bit quicker, and she's by herself, and she pricked her ears back up again, and she enjoyed it from there on.
You've ridden some nice two-year-olds already earlier on this season. I know that those big races have gone, but how good can this one be?
She's raw talent at the moment, so she's quite exciting for the owners. She's going to be a very nice horse.
Well, she's made you work, mate. Congratulations on the win.
Thanks, mate.
There's Jared Noski, winning jockey aboard a Fabergino.